Let your word be fulfilled in our lives. Let us be true representatives of Jesus in every area, in all ramifications. Let not the heathen say to us, where is their God? Let not the heathen say to us, where is the God we talk about? Thank you, Father. I pray for every brother, every sister here today, that your presence will leave this church with us today as never before.
Amen.
To do the impossible.
Amen.
To climb mountains.
Amen.
To jump and leap over valleys of life.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Sit down with a clap offering for Jesus. You may be seated. I want to talk on the unbeatable army of the Lord. The unbeatable army of the Lord. That can be found in the book of Joel, chapter 2. We will read as we identify this army and we see what the Lord wants to do in them, for them, and through them. We will be able to understand and be able to fit into this end time. I want to let you know, church, that the end time is different from the times that we have lived before. We are in a critical end time. Bad days have been prophesied by prophets, both prophets of the Bible and the prophets of now. So in several ways, bad days have been prophesied on. And today, as we see here, we will see that bad days have been talked about again in this scripture that I'm about to read to us, book of the prophet Joel, chapter 2. Prophet Joel, chapter 2. Bad days have been prophesied. Wars, earthquakes, rumors of war. I think Syria is now in about the 8th month or the 9th month. They're almost a year now. They've been in internal war. War against one another. And you know that all over the world, there is, where war is not happening, there are threats of war. In Nigeria, you might not say there is war, but there is war. It's not the way you are sitting down now that the brethren in the north are sitting down. Some of them have stopped coming to church because they are not sure what happens when they come to church. Some of them have almost taken of changing religion now because they are not sure whether this Christianity is real anyway. We are in the last days. Please remind your neighbor, we are in the last days. Now, when we talk about the last days, we're talking about the coming of Jesus, when he's about to come. Can you imagine nations where geographically earthquakes are not meant to happen? Hello? Earthquake. A geographer will tell you some of the things that must be around before an earthquake can happen in a place. There are signposts. But even nations now, where there are never in the history of such nations have earthquakes taken place. They are saying earthquake of serious magnitude. Thousands upon thousands of people being displaced. Even in Iran, recently, there was an earthquake. I don't think earthquake ever happened in that place before. If it did, it must be several centuries ago. Please look at your neighbor one more time. We are in the last days. Now, Jesus gave a lot of signals as to what the end out what we precede his arrival, and the last thing he said was that this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the nations. He said, then the end shall come. There are still some tribes, even in Nigeria, that are still trying to be reached. They are not fully reached yet, you know. But now, this is the good news. In the midst of the wars, of the earthquakes, of the premature deaths and all kinds of misfortunes, calamities upon calamities, God is raising up an army. There shall be the raising up of an army of the living God who are going to fulfill the end time programs of the living God. I'm excited this morning, and thank God that you are one of the army that God is raising up. If you accept that you are one of them, can I hear you shout to amen very well?
Amen.
And when we talk about an army, we're not talking about a delinquent people who are always quiet, they are doing nothing to the kingdom of the devil. You don't talk of the military if you are not talking about wars and victories. When we talk about an army, we're talking about a militant people. People who are always at the forefront. Not at the middle, not at the back. Not sleeping people. Not defeated people. Not people who are not weaklings. We're talking about men and women who are strong and militant for Jesus. Those are the ones we are talking about. They don't fear anything. And as we study this morning, may the Lord open your eyes to see what God expects of you as an army of the end time. Lift up your hand and say, I've enlisted in that army by being born again. And in the name of Jesus, this military will favor me. Say, I cannot be defeated. I cannot be oppressed. Come and shout it, I cannot be oppressed. In the name of Jesus, I refuse oppression. I refuse depression. I refuse defeat. I am in the army of the Lord. Give a shout of praise unto the Almighty. Now, Joel chapter 2, verse 2. We start from verse 2. The Bible says, a day of darkness and of gloominess, a day of clouds and of thick darkness, as the morning spread upon the mountains. Hallelujah. All I have said, I've explained that. We're in a terrible day of darkness, such as the world has never known. 15 years ago in America, if you talk about recession, oh, they will say, no, we are more than that. And even if it comes, we have all things on ground to cope that. They take care of many things years in advance. But I have a news to for you in America today. There are so many unemployed. I'm not even talking about Nigerians in America. I'm talking about white Americans. Unemployed. Darkness is all over the world. Darkness is all over the place. But watch this. Now, the B part of verse 2 says, a great people and a strong, there has not been ever the like, neither shall be any more after that even to the years of many generations. Now, so in the midst of the darkness, God is still in the business of raising up an army. Now you have a choice this morning to make up your mind that you want to be one of the military that God is raising up. Hallelujah. What we have is more than gun and bullet. What we have is more than all those long mouth aeroplanes that are now being brought out. You know, for every new war, America will bring out another. We are more than that. Are you hearing me? Look at your neighbor and say, aren't you glad you are in the army of the Lord? Oh, somebody may read this and say, oh, no, this is not talking about the church. It's talking about his people being defeated, and it's talking about an army of strangers being raised up. No. And when we go further, you will see where the Lord said, my army. Hallelujah. Where it is my army, I'm raising them up. Somebody praise the name of Jesus. And in verse 3, the Bible says, now, so when you read all of verse 2, we begin to see what shall characterize this army. What are we going to see in them? What are the features that will make us to identify that these are truly the army of the Lord? Why are they going to be different from every other person? What is going to be unique about them? And why will the darkness and the assaults of the darkness of this end time not be able to affect them? Hallelujah. Now, number one, take note of it in that same verse 2b, he said, they are a great people. Now, here when the Bible talks about great, it's talking about the number. They'll be multitude. There will be many. And I'm happy God is recruiting soldiers every day into his army all over the world. People are getting saved on a daily basis. And I pray, when people are getting saved and entering the kingdom, you won't be losing your own salvation. You didn't say amen to that. You will remain a soldier for the Lord. You won't just remain a born again. You'll be a soldier for Christ. You won't be an onlooker. Always at the defense. Never at the offense. You will be a real soldier for Christ. So they will be great. And number two, they will be strong. Let's spend some time on that. They'll be strong. The soldiers that form the army, the generality is the army, but you and I are soldiers in that army. They are not going to be weaklings, they will be strong. Strong in faith. And he's talking about all around strength. Economically, they will be strong. Hallelujah. Because you know how many billions Americans pump into war projects and a budget for war, budget for ammunitions. The ones undiscovered, every day they are doing research and getting new ones. Press TV carried American, what's the name of that one? No human being is in it. Just flies over and bomb anywhere they have signaled it to go. It's controlled by remote control. The drone, American drone now. They will be strong. Do like this, I say, I will be strong. Say, in the name of Jesus, I refuse to be a weakling. Say, devil, pack your weaknesses away from my life in the name of Jesus. Can I hear you say amen? I don't know the areas where the devil is bombarding you with weakness. The army of this end time that God is raising up are going to be strong people. Spiritually, they will be strong. When we say you are strong spiritually, what are we talking about? We are talking about your ability to obey instructions from above. So, where do you take instruction more than in the military? In the ministry, the person who is younger than you in age, once you are a recruit and is a major, he can give you instruction, right or wrong. And you have to say, yes, sir. Oh, no, Americans are the ones that do like this. Nigerians will do, yes, sir. Look at your neighbor, say, in Jesus' name, every weakness is living your life. We're talking about strength. Strength. Any soldier who is in war front and is not strong, he doesn't have the ammunition, he doesn't have the equipment. Anyway, they always say bye-bye to their siblings before they leave home. Have you ever seen the Marines going to Afghanistan, to Pakistan, you know, and they carry those bags and they are kissing their wives and they escort them as far as to where they can reach If you ever travel to the U.S., you are on the queue. You see soldiers who are on queue. Some of them are going to Afghanistan, some to Lebanon, and all those places. Do like this. I say, I'll be strong in the Lord and in the power of his mind. Can I hear you say amen to it?
Amen.
We can spend 2 hours talking about strength. God is not raising up an army of weaklings, complainants, latecomers. Spiritually, they are just not strong. They don't have the spiritual stamina to do anything spiritual. They have been breastfed, fed. They've been breastfed from the day they were born again. 5 years ago, they are still giving them butter and milk. Breastfeed, they have to call them to come to church. They have to announce to them everything and breastfeeding. They are not taking pandejam and ogbono yet, which is meant for only the strong adults. Look at your neighbor. Which one are you this? Are you strong or weak? They can't pray on their own. They are praying for me, brother. But this army are going to be strong people. Strong. And I have a news for you. They will be also economically strong. You see countries when no get money, they come out in the United Nations, they talk. What do they want to say? They are not recognized. Which countries have veto power? Huh? Not the wealthy ones. You see how UN had wanted to intervene in what is going on in Syria, and in their meeting, Russia will raise up hand. China go raise up, say, no way. Only strong people sabi talk. We're talking about economic strength. You will not be poor.
Amen.
You will not be poor your life. Because this prayer, what is going to happen today? I can't finish this topic today. Maybe I will finish it coming Sunday. Listen to me. Something is about to happen in your life. Heaven will begin to fight for you.
Amen.
Heavens will begin to work for you.
Amen.
Say your amen one more time. God is not raising up an army of beggars. No, sir. If you've been the welfare brother, you've been welfare brother all your life. Now make up your mind before you leave church today and say, Lord, in Jesus' name, I stop begging. If you can't bear my responsibility, I will never beg again in my life. You know why? That army, they will be strong. They'll be strong. They will be strong. Look at yourself and say, Father, the way I look at myself this morning, you better redress as I'm doing. I'm repackaging my dress. I look so strong. Say, I will be strong economically. I will be strong in my physical strength. I will be strong spiritually. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I refuse to be a weakling. Can I hear you shout, hey?
Amen.
Oh, Lord. Wherever we stop today, we continue coming Sunday. But I'm excited and I'm in the list of the army. How about you? Okay, if you're in the list, I want you for 2 minutes, pray for yourself. Say, I reject weakness. I reject no strength financially, in my physical health. I refuse. Let me hear you say, strength is my portion. I'm not giving in to weakness. I'm not giving in to defeat. I'm not giving in to every walk of darkness. I refuse to be weak. I refuse to be defeated. Open your mouth. What you don't want, refuse it now. And let me hear you say amen to it. Look at the next verse. Verse 3 says, a fire devoured before them, and behind them a flame burned. But this is not the first time we will see this. This is exactly what happened when the children of Israel left Egypt into the promised land. So many of us are on our way now to the promised land, and you will get there.
Amen.
I say you will get there.
Amen.
Somebody here will get there in the name of Jesus. Exactly what is written here is what happened to them. A fire was before them. Hallelujah. and flame behind them. What was the duty of the fire? Now here the Bible says it will devour. No enemy will be able to stand against them and succeed. So the response to the army, there shall be a fire, a devouring fire before them. And I believe very strongly he was talking about the anointing of the Holy Spirit. The Bible says, and there appeared to them, Acts chapter 2, I think verse 3, there appeared to them cloven tongues, like what? As of fire. So when you carry the Holy Spirit, you carry fire. If you don't have the fire, you don't have the power. Hallelujah. So when you carry the anointing, you are carrying fire. And that fire is supposed to also be for you, to go before you, to devour every spirit that stands before you that you won't get to where you are going. We devour them this morning.
Amen.
We devour them this morning.
Amen.
We devour them this morning.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Every spirit that appear before you and say they would delay your getting to the destination, we devour them this morning.
Amen.
We devour them this morning.
Amen.
We devour them this morning.
Amen.
Let your amen be born again. Say your amen very well. Fire shall go before them. They are not people you can easily beat. They are not people demons can easily mesmerize. Because there is a fire. Somebody shout fire, fire. Shall go before them to devour. To devour. And behind them, now the one that is before them is going to perform notable functions. The first one is to devour and to destroy whatever is before them. And number two, it is also supposed to show light to their path. Am I right? Am I right? If there's fire in your front, it will show you where you are going now. So they won't be beating around the bush. Try and error. They do one business today, there's no sabbath, they don't, they think no work, they try another. Nobody try and error, they will know where they are going. Can I hear you say amen?
Amen.
The anointing is sufficient to make these provisions for us. The anointing with which you were baptized and you spoke in tongues, it has the capability of not only fighting against the adversary in your life, it also has the capability of divine direction. 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 Somebody say amen this morning.
Amen.
And then fire will be behind them to do what? Always protecting them against the coming enemies. Never again that those who are chasing after you, they won't catch up with you.
Amen.
Say your amen one more time.
Amen.
You didn't understand my prayer. I said people chasing after you, they want to kill you before your time. They don't want you to just make that dream of your life. That was how Joseph experienced. They didn't want him to make that dream. That dream was too big for them to comprehend. When you get a dream, you have two kinds of people. People who celebrate your dream and people who are jealous of your dream. But more seriously, you have demon spirits who know that your dream, the fulfillment of your dream is a plus to the kingdom of God. And they want to fight. They want to beat. They want to do everything so that that dream may not just come to a reality. We stand on authority this morning in the name of Jesus. The anointing on your life will fight. May the anointing on your life begin to fight. May the anointing upon your life begin to fight. Say your amen two more times, everybody. Fire. Devoured before them and behind them a flame burned. Number four now, it says, the land is as the Garden of Eden before them. Wow. And behind them a desolate wilderness, yea, and nothing shall escape them. There are so many things mentioned here. The land shall be like the land of Canaan before them. The land shall, what was the land of Eden, sorry? The land of Eden before them. Interestingly, as far as the people left Egypt were concerned, The land called Canaan was like lack of Eden for them. Are you still with me? Every one of us on the journey of life here, you are born again, you are in the list of the army of the Lord. The land shall be like Eden before you. It's not the one behind you that will be like Eden. Because some people, they can testify of when they were millionaires 5 years ago. When things was working well, everything was fine. That was Eden time. But here, Eden is not going to be at your back. It will be in your front. Oh, you didn't understand what I'm talking about. Your life will not be a proverb. If right now you are having an Eden experience, it won't die off your life. All we can do is to just trust God to make it better and better and better and better for you. Because some people have had Eden experience before. Now, God says that the back one will be a wilderness. Did you hear me? Will be a wilderness before them. Now, so the garden, the land, which is going to be like the Garden of Eden, number one, look at seven things about the Garden of Eden. The land that you're expecting to reach, number one, is a place of God's visitation. God will visit you continually as from now in the name of the Lord Jesus. Number two, it's a place where you commune with God. You have a fellowship with God and God fellowships with you continually. Number three, it's a place of no toiling. Adam and Eve didn't toil and toil and toil and toil and suffer, 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 suffer with nothing to eat. Hello? Garden of Eden. How many of you remember Garden of Eden? When they want to take mango, they say, oh, mango, they just plod. When they wanted to take which one again? Huh? Ogbono must have been one corner of that garden. Every corner, something they needed was there. God says, for this army, not so their front go be. What is before you is better than what is behind you, sister. I'm talking to a sister here. You are discouraged. You are perplexed, almost defeated, almost accepting a defeat. Hear the word of the Lord. What is in your front is better than what is behind you. Somebody shout three times, I received that for myself. So number three, it's not a toiling thing. Many of us have toiled and toiled and toiled. I speak to your life that your resting time has finally come. Amen. Your relaxing time has finally come. Amen. Say your amen one more time. Amen. Money will come for you. Amen. People will respond to you. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. And let me hear your amen one more time. Number four is not a place where they lagged. I don't know whether you ever read that Adam and Eve, one day they sat and they say, oh God, we needed this and we couldn't find it. No needs. They were Solomon. If you are talking of Eden because God just created them, we will say, okay, it was because they were just created. No. Solomon said, there's no scarceness of anything. There's no adversity, no evil occurrence. And when God was taking them from Deuteronomy chapter 9 to the land of Canaan, he said, in that land, when you get there, what will happen? There shall be no scarceness of any. For how long will your own life be with scarcity, 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 struggle, struggle, struggle? From today, enter the next phase. Enter the next phase. Amen. Enter the next phase. Amen. Let me hear your amen one more time. Amen. You are not just going to have sufficient for yourself. You are going to have for your family. You are going to have for the work of the ministry. Now watch this. The end time army is an army prepared. They are vessels of honor, sanctified and meet for the master's use. So So when we're talking about prosperity and provision, we're not talking about just something for you and your family and yourself and your children. We're talking about being a great sponsor of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We're talking about the millions. We're talking about the billions. And I won't stop prophesying it to your life, because you have to get it. This is the season for it. This is the season for it. When our pastor said that he will work 3 months, then 3 months, then 3 months, each of the 3 months for the foundation, each of the 3 months, they will give him one million. That's out of his salary. That's out of salary. 3 months out of his salary. Who told you that another phone call cannot ring for him? Who told him another phone call cannot ring? I want you to begin to see an Eden before you. Tell your neighbor, what can you see? Because what you can see is what you can have. Until you can conceive it, you can't achieve it. Conceive it, begin to see it from this morning. And the word of this prophecy will be fulfilled in your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus. An Eden before them, an Eden. The garden of Eden shall be in their front, where the wilderness shall be at their back. I don't know what you have gone through before, but that's behind. Do like this and say it's behind. Do it by faith or say it's behind. It's behind. Even if you came to this church this morning with it, it's already going behind. Every wilderness experience, say it. Every wilderness experience, behind, 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 behind. So don't forget, number 5 is a place to have dominion. Garden of Eden is a place of dominion. That's number 5 thing that the Garden of Eden, God was talking about dominion. They said, you are going to be called a hyena. You, a lion. We will call you a four tete. Tete. Ele will be so called your koto. Abi. This one will be Gure. It was a place of dominion. They were the one who gave name to everything. You will be called lion. You na hyena. You cow. You dog. We're in the end time. There must be a release, total release of all these things back to the church. And you are partakers of these things. In the name of the Lord Jesus. So that's number what? Number 6 or 7? It's a place of dominion. Total and absolute dominion. You will have dominion over the devil. You will have dominion over money. Money is not going to be your master. Money is not going to control you. Money is not going to be dictating the pace of your life. You are going to be in charge. That is the plan of God. That is his program. For the end time army, somebody shouts, yes. And then, let me mention 2 more. It's a place where you eat only good things. No junks. There are some of you who are bachelors. Now, only coke and meat pie. Chicken pie is even a little better. But now, only gala. When I was a small boy, always traveling from where I would go and join train in Ofa that would carry me to Zaria to school in those days. Gala. If you move near me itself, I become gala. You know, people take some of those things too much, they smell it. You remind me when I was an undergraduate, some people, when they come, You had geisha today. Because when I talk, my mouth geisha smell. Oh my God. We thank God. We thank God. So that you're a bachelor doesn't mean you have to be eating, drinking Coke. Some take 3 bottles of Coke a day. Why? Tell your neighbor, you better learn how to cook. Because when coke begin to deal with you. Hallelujah. In the Garden of Eden, not only good things. And finally, in the Garden of Eden, longevity was real. In fact, they were not to die. Am I right? They were not to die. Longevity was a reality. We're talking about the end time army. God says they are front, before them, the Garden of Eden. Behind them, I'm going to stop here today. We continue coming Sunday. Because you have to be in that army by force. Hello? In Israel, when you reach a particular age, you must be recruited into the army, right or wrong? In the state of Israel. It's part of the law of the land. Hallelujah. Because there are not so many in population, but their enemies are too many. So, once you reach a particular age, when you enter Israel, the state of Israel, wherever, and you see soldiers, beautiful young girls jump from their trucks with guns. Girls! I watch. I'm talking of girls. Soldiers are everywhere. You know, I wanted to be a soldier too. I told you that story long ago. You know, some of my friends discouraged me. They say, you too want to go and do Nigerian military school. They say they don't want K-leg. They don't want people weigh. Let's rise up and pray. The first prayer today, Lord, I have enlisted in the army. I will not be retired. Pray in the name of Jesus. Nakosote yamakoli batosoya. Legra batoso. Brena goson tayaba. Melozoten debiko tuso. Ah. Lord, I will not be cut off from this army of the living God. Ye mama ole sandayabus. Brego son to yamakosa. Rega sendo yimakoli abaluze yebo. Everything that is made for me as a member of the army of Christ. Res kopo so yabana koloboto shia. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I didn't hear you, amen, very well. Amen. Deal with that weakness now. Some of you talk too much. Soldiers, don't they talk too much? If you leak secret, they will put you for jail. There is a military jail. That place is tough. And there's no respect. It's only in Nigeria, you know, you can bribe and do everything. In other countries, there's no regard for whether you're a brigadier general or a major general. When they pick you, they are not careless people. Even when journalists come interview a soldier and ask him something, now he go talk small. He don't want to commit himself. He don't want to leak secrets. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Every weakness that make me not to be strong, capable, able, faithful, loyal in the military of the Lord that I have enlisted to, Lord, I refuse them. Some of you may see, maybe you are still a fornicator, you are still an adulterer, you are still carry lust for your eyes. Now every woman where you see, you want to sleep with. In the place of work, you still steal small. And you say you're there for the military. Yeah. Which military you day? The soldier of the Lord, no day like that. You can go and marry, oh. And those of you who are married and who still do weary with your eyes. I pray that eyes not go pluck out one day. Oh. We will call the name just one time. Lord, I command, I receive strength. I reject this weakness. I refuse that. Shall we pray in the name of Jesus? Yes, Lord. Makosote ya bababa. Bre sopo na sayobo luz. Regege esko ya. Banato sopo nde yebo. Ah, Oluwa. Reke skeli proboto se. Meto soponde yabos. Yes, Lord. Every weakness that make me not a real soldier of Jesus. Manto sopoligo seya. Regrobato seyabos. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Is God answering your prayer?
Yes.
The last prayer. Lord, I command the Garden of Eden to be a reality in my life. Please listen very well to this prayer. Because coming Sunday, as we go on in the depth of this teaching, you will see that these soldiers have the different segments. Segments. They have the business segment, the professional segment, all these people are going to be stinkingly rich. There's no war that you can do in poverty. Are you hearing me? No war is really carried out in poverty. Obama stood up the other day and he was announcing, he said, America has been the leader in terms of ammunition, in his tenure. He wants to even double that. No country that is where they want to come down. You will not come down.
Amen.
Last prayer. As we call the name Jesus, everything that resembles Garden of Eden, I speak it to my life. I won't be poor. I won't die young. I will have enough to eat for my family, and I will sponsor the gospel of Jesus Christ. Pray in the name of Jesus. Guardian of Eden experience. Rabatos, all Garden of Eden experience. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Right now, Lord, I stand as your servant and face this congregation. And I say, let new doors be opened before you. Not the kind of businesses you have been handling before, but the new dimension. Those men, those women who are meant to connect with you, I command them to reality. 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 Wherever they are, whether they are home or abroad, let them begin to surface. Let them begin to surface. Let them begin to call you on phone. Let them begin to connect with you. Let them begin to connect with you. Let them begin to connect with you. It is our time to make it. We are in the army of the Lord. Receive the anointing. Give him praise, everybody, this morning. Give him the glory. 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 Give him praise. Marobo sonte yabaluga. Blaboto sonde yemakoshi yaba. Legorobo sonte yababa. Every sickness is healed this morning. You are not going back with that symptom. That symptom of headache that you came in with. You came in by pain. That chest pain that you came with is healed now. Is healed now. Is healed now. That bad sleep you had last night, we decree it will come tonight. The enemy that you saw yesterday, they have become a wilderness before you. It is a week of the Garden of Eden. We declare it the week of the Garden of Eden. Let me, and you shout three times, I receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Thank you, Father. Please, can you congratulate four people? Tell them, I see the Garden of Eden before you and wilderness behind.